Your Voice, a program for you to see how your concerns are being heard in the New York State Senate with Senator George Maziarz. I'm Julia Locandy.
Good morning, Julia.
Hi, Senator. How are you today?
Excellent. Yourself?
Very good.
That's good.
So the New York Dream Act, it is for undocumented students to be able to have financial aid. The Assembly passed it. The Senate put it up on the floor. It didn't go through, but how did you vote?
I voted no. It failed by just two votes in the Senate. I am absolutely, totally in opposition to it. I think that providing state funding for individuals that are not legal residents of the United States of America, let alone New York State, is just poor public policy. You sort of have to wonder this on top of the college for prison inmates, just what direction we're headed. And the fact that many of my constituents who have emailed me back on this issue were stunned to see that it failed by only two votes and that it passed the New York State Assembly. I will continue in my opposition to this legislation. I think it's extremely poor. There are so many working families out there today that struggle to send their children to college. I get emails from people all the time who talk about the debt load that they have from student loans, the cost of college today. It's very difficult. To say that we're going to take state resources and give them to people that are here illegally, let them work towards, a legal citizenship, and then, become a part of, the process to, go to college and, work hard like I did, members of my family, like my constituents have done.
Right, and these students are able to get in-state tuition, right?
Yes, yeah, they are able to get in-state tuition, yes, which, is further. I mean, if there's any incentives given, it should be given to New York State residents who are here, who are American citizens. And I've received a lot of almost all the emails in my particular district are opposed to this. I clearly understand my colleagues, some of whom represent districts that are, heavily populated with immigrants, some of which are legal, and some of which are not. Yet the overwhelming majority of the emails that I have received on this particular subject, and in going around my district in the last week since I made this vote, I can say that. I think my vote is where my constituents want me to be. It's where I personally feel, and I have no regrets. There are, of course, always naysayers out there, and those people who support this legislation, they certainly have a right to their opinion.
Right. And the budget's coming up, and you will be supporting tuition assistance for college students.
Tuition assistance for New York State residents who live here, who work here, middle class families who struggle every day pay their bills, pay their taxes, and who are trying to get a better life for their kids. That's the way my mother and father did it, with nine children, and that's the way I did it. And I think that it's the system, and people should strive to, number one, get legal citizenship, and live the American dream like everybody else did.
Now let's talk about a true American hero, a constituent from your district. He earned the highest award given to military personnel for action in a battlefield.
Yes.
Tell us about
it. Medal of Honor. I couldn't be more proud. I have to tell you, one of the proudest days that I've ever had during my service. That is a PFC William Leonard. He is now deceased. He passed away a long time ago. Those are his three daughters there, two of whom still live in Lockport. The third one lives in Louisiana. They accepted the Medal of Honor from President Obama in Washington, D.C., in the White House, on behalf of their dad, who I said passed away almost 30 years ago now. There they are. On the left there is the Secretary of Defense, Chuck Hagel, Defense Secretary Hagel. Then next to him is John McHugh, the last person there on our left, I guess the viewer's right, is John McHugh. He's a Secretary of the Army and a former New York State Senator. He was a state senator from the North Country, where Patty Ritchie's district is now. He later went on to Congress and was appointed Secretary of the Army. That, again, is Private Leonard's daughter, accepting the Medal of Honor flag at the Pentagon from the Secretary of Defense and Secretary of the Army. This was on Tuesday. On Monday, they were at the White House and received the actual medal from President Obama, as did 23 other. There were a total of 24 recipients of the Medal of Honor from World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. Only three of the 24 are actually living, and those three were there. And that is Ann McCaffrey. Ann is the mayor of the city of Lockport. Ann went with me to the ceremony. We met there. We were invited by the family and by Congressman Chris Collins. We were standing in front of the citation that was approved by the president for William Leonard's service in World War II, where he, under enemy fire, saved numerous of his comrades' lives, took out many of the enemy. That's a little funny story here. That's actually a cake. At the Pentagon, they had a reception afterwards, and they had this huge cake with the name of each one of the 24 recipients from World War II, Korea, and the Vietnam War on the cake. That was before they cut the cake. Mr. Leonard's daughters thought it was a great thing to take a picture of the cake there. And nobody wanted to cut it afterwards. But, you know, being there, I've never done that before. You know, these medals are not given out, you know, with any degree of regularity. This is a solemn occasion in our country when an individual is awarded the Medal of Honor. Many times people make mistakes. They call it the Congressional Medal of Honor. That's not the name of it. It's actually just referred to as the Medal of Honor. It can only be approved and given by the President of the United States, and it has to be for heroism in action under combat, where you save the lives of your comrades or of allied soldiers. Some of the stories were just absolutely remarkable. How this all came about was Congress back in 2000. There was a report that some Hispanic and Jewish war veterans in World War II, Korea particularly, and in Vietnam, were denied the Medal of Honor, or their heroism was not sent up the chain of command strictly because of their race, ethnicity, and religion. And they started to investigate that. And what they found was that there were also several instances. Private Leonard, William Leonard, is neither Jewish nor is he Hispanic. But they found that there were also some other cases where individuals' records had not been transferred up the regular chain of command to the president at the time. Would have been William Leonard's case, it would have been President Truman, I believe. So they were able to rectify that, and I can tell you, from having sat there in the Pentagon and listened to them read in full each one of those 24 citations, these individuals certainly were worthy and deserving. As I mentioned, the Medal of Honor is almost always given posthumously because a person is killed in action. You know, there were several of the citations when they were read where you knew that the individual soldier, they were surrounded by the enemy or their camp was overrun, and the soldier told everyone else to retreat, to go back, to escape, to run, and he would stay there and hold off the enemy, knowing that it was certain death. And there were, I think, three of the 24, the citations were of that nature. And, you know, it was just an amazing story. And these are everyday soldiers. One was a company clerk in Vietnam, and they were surrounded, and he did that. He told everybody to leave, and he would stay and hold the enemy off. Now, he was able to escape and get back. He was actually one of the three that were there in person. But, you know, the ceremony at the White House, Mr. Leonard's daughter said, was just amazing. The president was extremely gracious to them, and as I'm sure anyone would be. We do, Mayor McCaffrey plans on having a ceremony back in Lockport to honor William Leonard. His two of his daughters, as I said, still live there. So it was just a great day. It's probably one of the greatest days that I've had to go to the Pentagon and to meet the Secretary of Defense. And John McHugh, I knew the Secretary of the Army. He didn't serve when I was here in the Senate, but he served here for several terms in the New York State Senate. So it was just to be there with their families. Lenny Kravitz, his uncle was awarded the Medal of Honor, and he was there. So everyone wanted to get their picture taken with him. His uncle was awarded the Medal of Honor, and I thought he did a very classy thing. He did not go up to receive the medal. He, because only one family member could go up there and receive the medal. So they had to sort of like make arrangements among themselves who was. And obviously when it was his uncle's turn, you would think that he would go up, but he allowed his uncle's brother, another relative, to go up to receive the medal. So, and who was a much older gentleman, and I thought it was a nice thing to do.
Oh, that's very nice.
It was, but again, I just want to stress that Mayor McCaffrey was there with me, and we are planning on doing some sort of a ceremony back in Lockport with Mr. Leonard's daughters to basically, have the local people. I mean, they only had, I think, they were only able to get, I think Congressman Collins was actually only able to get like 3 or 4 invitations, and he invited myself and Mayor McCaffrey, so it was a great day.
Right. So he has received a lot of awards. It's great that he finally gets this
distinguished. Yes, yes, yes. He received several medals. He received the second highest medal that you could get, and but he's clearly deserved the Medal of Honor. And as the Secretary of Defense said, it's never too late to right a wrong. And on that Tuesday and that Monday and Tuesday in Washington, D.C., our country righted a very big wrong.
Right. 24 times.
Yes. A rally to save a hospital in your district.
Yes.
Tell us about that one.
Last Saturday, I was Supervisor Tim Hornburg, had a rally in Newfane to save the Newfane Hospital. It's a small hospital located, and it happens to be the town where I live. And the supervisor, Tim Hornburg, there's talk. Now, the hospital has it's a hospital system. There are two hospitals, actually, one in Lockport, one in Newfane. And the board of directors and the CEO have said that there's no plans yet to close it. But it is struggling. They've had a number of layoffs, which is not a good sign. We just wanted to show that there's community support. And really, the community wants and deserves some answers from the board on what the financial viability of the hospital is, what we have to do as residents to save that hospital. And I think now there's been a series of meetings scheduled because of these rallies and because of these questions, and we're going to get some answers for the residents. But it's an important part of our community. It should stay open.
Right. And SUNY Brockport, you were there this weekend?
Yes, a CareNet Pregnancy Crisis Center dinner. It was very well attended. I can only tell you that these people do great work. They help young women out in a very difficult time in their lives. CareNet Pregnancy Centers do great work. There's one in Lockport. This one is the Orleans County one. I had the dinner in Brockport, but there was a lot of people there.
And you spent some time with some NRA.
Yes, I went to the NRA dinner, the Western New York NRA dinner at Salvatore's. Another excellent turnout. Had a whole table there from Niagara County that I sponsored. Some really good people. Bill Hiltz Sr. was there. He's like, the senior sportsman of Ann Fisher person of all Western New York, I think.
So they're probably talking to you about things they'd like to see in the budget
yes.
as well.
Yes, yes.
So next time you come back, we could talk about the budget.
We will.
All right.
Okay.
Thanks. Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator George Maziarz. For additional information, maziarz.nysenate.gov.